Amid all the doom and gloom surrounding the coronavirus pandemic, a good news story has emerged down here in West Sussex. A stork reintroduction programme has seen the successful birth of baby stork hatchlings for the first time in Britain for centuries.
More than 100 birds have been bred in captivity and released at three locations in West Sussex and Surrey, including the Knepp Estate, a 3,500-acre former dairy farm that was rewilded at the turn of the century.
The White Stork Project started in 2016, and it's a partnership of private landowners and nature conservation charities who have an aim to restore white storks to the south of England. So the reintroduction has been done over three separate phases. So the first phase is to establish a sedentary, static population. So these are birds that were injured in the wild in Poland. Despite being rehabilitated, they won't recover their flight, and they form our resident population. So they act like a magnet for any that might be flying over. They will also form a static breeding population as well. So their young will be able to release themselves once they're fledged. The second phase is to have a resident population who are free flying, but they know that Knepp is their home. So again, rehabilitated birds from Poland, but these guys can fly. They're kept here for two winters before being released, and that imprints them on the site. So although they can fly around Sussex and the country, they usually return to Knepp. And then the third phase is introducing a migratory population, and that's done by captive breeding. So, and they have the instincts to migrate, so they will fly south for the winter. So we've got a number of storks free flying around the south of England, and people can get involved by helping us report sightings. So all of our birds are wearing a large blue ring on their upper left leg, which always start with the letters GB written in white and then followed by a number or a letter combination. And those sightings can be reported to us via our Twitter, which is @ProjectStork, or via the website.
Bill clattering, the social display between the mating pair as one returns from feeding to take over the nest. Storks are monogamous, and last year a pair laid eggs in a treetop at Knepp, but the eggs did not hatch. With two nests confirmed as successfully hatching three chicks each, conservationists have high hopes that the first wild-born storks will lead to a growth in the stork population across Britain.
We thought they'd escaped or something had happened, because we were seeing these storks. We'd never seen a stork here in our lives. And suddenly you had I presume African, European white storks that are flying over the country, had spotted these little white spots down on the ground and come to visit us. Last Saturday, we were seeing storks regurgitating stuff into their nest. So we got two nests that we now have three chicks in each nest. So, yeah, just lovely, lovely news. Our first bird that is one of the breeding birds now, she flew off to France in the spring of 2017. And she only turned up in 2019, and then has laid the three eggs and has just hatched out three chicks in this wonderful spring we're having now.
20 years ago, the Knepp Estate began a rewilding project, allowing nature to recover. It's now a hotspot for endangered species, including nightingales, turtle doves, and purple emperor butterflies. Free-roaming cattle, red deer, Exmoor ponies, and Tamworth pigs mimic the grazing patterns of extinct herbivores, which over time is believed to support the restoration of a more natural ecosystem. The Stork Reinforcement Project at Knepp aims to have 30 wild pairs of storks by 2030.
It's kind of like being new parents. we have just had the first successful hatching of chicks. So these are two free-flying storks, and the last time that storks were recorded nesting in Britain was in 1416, so the year after Agincourt, and they were recorded nesting on St. Giles Cathedral in Edinburgh. What's very exciting about the two nests that we have is that one pair of birds One of them is a wild bird that has paired up with one of our pen birds. So that's very exciting. It's showing that already this little cohort that's hefted to Knepp is already attracting wild birds from Europe. And then the other nest is one of the pair was a pen bird again that escaped the pen in the very early days. Somehow she managed to escape even though she had clipped wings. And she flew over to Europe and spent a year and a half in Europe and then flew back into the pen, paired up with one of her original cohort and has made this nest and had hatched three chicks. So we can see that there's also a migration instinct already in our birds too. So they will be joining wild populations soon. You know, it's so interesting. And when you go to Europe, you know, you see them building their shaggy nests on top of school buildings, village halls, churches, you name it. People love them so much in Europe. They're a symbol of rebirth and rejuvenation. That's why we have this idea of, you know, the myth of the storks bringing babies in their beaks. In a funny kind of way, it just seems to chime with this whole weird situation we're in with COVID-19, I think. You know, they started incubating their eggs pretty much, you know, and building their nests and then incubating their eggs pretty much when we were going into lockdown. And now just as we're beginning to think of opening up again, you know, there we are with the chicks coming out of their eggs, and they'll be fledging, you know, in about a month and a half. So it kind of feels like they've been mirroring, you know, this sort of weird space that we've been in. But also I think there has been so much more attention to nature since we've been in lockdown, but I think there's still this lovely seed of hope and, like a stork, the new beginnings that might come out of this whole situation into how we could think differently about nature and our landscapes when this is all over.